The second plenary meeting is resumed. We shall continue this morning with the election of four judges. Before we proceed, I would like to remind all delegations of the guidelines adopted by the Bureau on 4th October 2023 for enhancing the security of participants in the assembly sessions and side events. And in particular, Annex 1, Section 2.1, as regards refraining from taking pictures or making audio or visual recordings of participants without their consent. Please do not take pictures or videos of others without their consent. You can take selfies of yourself and of course of groups and those who consent, but please refrain from taking pictures or videos. I would like also to remind you that in application of Rule 68 of the Rules of Procedure of the Assembly, after the President has announced the commencement of voting, no representative of a state party may interrupt the voting, except that representatives of state parties may interrupt on a point of order in connection with the actual conduct of the voting. Thus, any announcement, such as the withdrawal of a candidate, must be made before the start of the voting procedure, that is to say, before the announcement of the beginning of the vote. If no one wishes to make an announcement at this point, we will then proceed to the third round of balloting to elect four judges of the International Criminal Court. I now request the conference officers to distribute the ballot papers. Representatives are requested to use only the ballot papers that are being distributed. This morning, they are light blue. Only those candidates whose names appear on the ballot papers are eligible for election. Representatives shall vote for a maximum of four. I repeat, four candidates by placing an X in the box to the left of the names on the ballot. Ballots containing votes for more than four candidates shall be declared invalid. Representatives are requested to vote for at least one candidate from the group of Asia-Pacific states and at least one candidate from the group of Eastern European states. Ballots that do not satisfy these regional minimum voting requirements will be declared invalid. Representatives are requested to vote for at least two male candidates. Ballots that do not satisfy this gender minimum voting requirement will also be declared invalid. So you are requested to vote for at least one candidate from Asia Pacific, one from the group of Eastern European states, and for two males at least. But if you have respected the minimum number of votes required for all the above categories, with less than four votes, you can abstain from voting for the other candidates. Again, it is a maximum of four. You could vote for less, provided that you meet all the requirements. I ask delegations please to check the ballots one more time one more time, and make sure that you have voted for no more than four, at least one from Asia, one from Eastern European states, and at least two male candidates. In case you have made a mistake and you wish to replace your ballot, you may bring the old ballot to the table in front of the podium and a new ballot will be provided. If you have made a mistake, please come and we'll replace your ballot, but bring your ballot. Delegations that have not received a ballot paper will be invited to approach the podium to receive one and cast their vote in a few minutes. Now we shall collect those who have been distributed. I invite the tellers to accompany the conference officers as they collect the ballot papers. I now request delegations that have not voted to do so now by approaching the podium to pick up a ballot paper and cast their vote. Delegations that have not voted yet are now invited to approach the podium. Excuse me, but we have already indicated that you are not allowed to take pictures of delegations. Please refrain from taking photos from delegations and videos. It is a historic moment. We do understand you wish to take photos, but you cannot, please. Thank you. I repeat, you cannot take pictures of delegations, of candidates, without their consent. Please. If there is any delegation that has not yet voted, please approach the podium and we'll give you a ballot. If there are no further delegations that wish to approach the podium, the voting is now closed. No more ballot papers will be accepted. I request delegates to please remain in their seats until the tellers, the conference officers, and I have left the room. I thank you, and we shall reconvene in 50 minutes. That is. That is 11:05. 11:05, we will be back. Distinguished delegates, please regain your seats. The second plenary meeting is resumed. The results of the third round of balloting are as follows. Number of ballot papers, 121. Number of invalids, ballots, 5. Number of abstentions, 0. Number of valid ballots, 116. Number of state parties voting, 116. Two-thirds required majority, 78. Number of votes obtained. Ben Mahfoud Haikel, Tunisia, 51. Dembélé Adelaide, Burkina Faso, 5. Guillou Nicolas, France, 67. Hochler Betty, Slovenia, 61. Hohoff Ute, Germany, 26. Lazarova Travkovska Mirjana, North Macedonia, 26. Nelson Clarence, Samoa, 54. Paek Kebong, Republic of Korea, 69. Parmas Andres, Estonia, 51. Rajaona Andriamanankadrianana, Madagascar, 35. Zeman Pavel, 15. No candidate has received the required two-thirds majority of states' parties present and voting. No candidate has been elected in the third round of balloting. The assembly has to proceed to a fourth round of balloting as four seats remained to be filled. The minimum voting requirement of at least one candidate from the group of Asia-Pacific states and at least one from the group of Eastern European states and two male candidates are maintained. While we wait for the ballots, I would like to remind you again that in application of Rule 68 of the Rules of Procedure of the Assembly, after the President has announced the commencement of the voting, no representative of a state party may interrupt the voting, except that representatives of state parties may interrupt on a point of order in connection with the actual conduct of the voting. Thus, any announcement, such as the withdrawal of a candidate, must be made before the start of the voting procedure, that is to say, before the announcement of the beginning of the vote. If there is any delegation that wishes to make an announcement, you can make announcements now. I see no requests from the floor, so we will now proceed to the fourth round of ballotings to elect four judges of the International Criminal Court. We will be distributing the ballot papers in a minute. Representatives will be requested to use only the ballot papers that will be distributed. Only those candidates whose names appear on the ballot papers are eligible for election. Representatives shall vote for a maximum of four, I repeat, four candidates by placing an X in the box to the left of their names on the ballots. Ballots containing votes for more than four candidates shall be declared invalid. Please do check the numbers, because some of the invalid votes is because they are more than the required one, that is a maximum of four. So please do count when you double check at the end. Representatives are requested to vote for at least one candidate from the group of Asia Pacific states and at least one candidate from the group of Eastern European states. Ballots that do not satisfy these regional minimum voting requirements will be declared invalid. So please double check that you have at least one from Asia Pacific and one from the group of Eastern European candidates. And also, representatives are requested to vote for at least two male candidates. Again, ballots that do not satisfy this gender minimum voting requirement will be declared invalid. If you have respected the minimum number of votes required for all the above categories with less than four votes, you can abstain from voting from others. So the requirement is that you don't go beyond four, but you can vote for less than four, provided that you do meet all the requirements. So I now request the conference officers to distribute the ballot papers. Please distribute the ballot papers. I kindly request you, all of you, to double-check the ballots. Check your ballots one more time to make sure that you have voted for no more than four candidates, at least one from the group of Asia-Pacific states, at least one from the group of Eastern European states, and at least two male candidates. In case you have made a mistake, you can replace your ballot. You may bring the old ballot here to the table in front of the podium, and we will give you another ballot. If you haven't made a mistake, you can replace it, and we will give you a new ballot. No mistakes, you have double checked. Now, we shall now proceed to the collection of ballot papers. Delegations that have not received the ballot paper, please wait. We will collect the ballot papers now, and then we will invite you to approach the podium. Now, I invite the tellers to accompany the conference officers as they collect the ballot papers. May I request delegations that have not voted to do so now by approaching the podium to pick up the ballot? If there is a delegation that didn't vote, we can approach the podium now. The voting is now closed. No more ballot papers will be accepted. I request delegates to remain in their seats until the tellers, the conference officers, and I have left the room. We shall reconvene at 12:10. Distinguished delegates, please regain your seats. The second plenary meeting is resumed. The results of the fourth round of balloting are as follows. Number of ballot papers, 122. Number of invalid ballots, 1. Number of abstentions, 0. Number of valid ballots, 121. Number of state parties voting, 121. Two-thirds required majority, 81. Number of votes obtained. Ben Mahfoud Haikel, Tunisia, 58. Dembélé Adelaide, Burkina Faso, 7. Guillou Nicolas, France, 71. Hochler Betty, Slovenia, 60. Hohoff Ute, Germany, 22. Lazarova Travkovska Mirjana, North Macedonia, 25. Nelson Clarence, Samoa, 52. Pae Kibong, Republic of Korea, 79. Parmas Andres, Estonia, 53. Rajaona Andriamanankadrianana, Madagascar, 32. Zeman Pavel, Czech Republic, 17. So, no candidate has received the required two-thirds majority of state parties present and voting. So, no candidate has been elected in the fourth round of balloting. So the Assembly has now to proceed to a fifth round of balloting as four seats remain to be filled. At this point, I would like to recall that paragraph 21 of the Assembly Resolution ICC ASP/3 Resolution 6 reads as follows. Each minimum voting requirement shall be adjusted until that requirement cannot no longer be met, whereupon the use of that requirement shall be discontinued. If an adjusted voting requirement can be met individually but not jointly, the use of all regional and gender voting requirements shall be discontinued. If following four ballots there still remain seats to be filled, these minimum voting requirements shall be discontinued. The minimum voting requirement regarding list A and B shall be applied until they are fulfilled. In very simple terms, there are no more minimum voting requirements from now on, because the requirements of list A and B have been fulfilled. So there are no more minimum voting requirements, but we still need to vote for four, and no more than four. Now, moreover, paragraph 23 of the same resolution reads, once regional and gender voting requirements are discontinued, and the minimum voting requirements regarding list A and B are fulfilled, each further ballot shall be restricted to the most successful candidates of the previous ballot. Before each ballot, the candidate, or in the event of a tie, the candidates, having obtained the lowest number of votes in the previous ballot shall thus be excluded, provided that the number of candidates remains at least twice the number of seats to be filled. In simple terms, the candidate, the one candidate, or two if there was a tie, but there's none, one candidate has the lowest number of votes shall thus be excluded. At this point in time, I would suggest to suspend our meeting for 10 minutes until 12:30, so you have the time to reflect and consider any withdrawals, and you communicate these withdrawals to us. So we will suspend until 12:30 so we can prepare the fifth ballot accordingly. The fifth ballot, in any case, will have to be prepared in accordance with the rules I have just read out. So I will suspend the meeting for 15 minutes, yes, and 12:30, 12:35, to give delegations the opportunity to consider possible withdrawals. So the meeting is suspended until 12:35. Thank you. Distinguished delegates, you have had some time to reflect on potential withdrawals. At this point, I would like to announce that the delegation of Burkina Faso has indicated to us their intention to withdraw. No other delegation has indicated their wish to withdraw at this point, so we are preparing the ballots with this change, and the ballots will be distributed shortly. We are going to have the fifth ballot in the morning and use the time that we still have, and then we will come back at 3 o'clock as scheduled to announce the results and continue with the voting. So at this point, I ask you to be a little bit patient and wait for a few minutes until we have the ballots and this can be distributed.
Thank you.
Distinguished delegates, again, I would like to remind you that in application of Rule 68 of the Rules of Procedure of the Assembly, after the President has announced the commencement of the voting, no representative of a state party may interrupt the voting, except that representatives of state parties may interrupt on a point of order in connection with the actual conduct of the voting. We will now proceed to the fifth round of balloting to elect four judges of the International Criminal Court. I now request the conference officers to distribute the ballot papers. As I told you before, representatives are now requested to use only the ballot papers that are being distributed. Only those candidates whose name appear on the ballot papers are eligible for election. Representatives shall vote for a maximum of four candidates by placing an X in the box to the left of their names on the ballot. Ballots containing votes for more than four shall be declared invalid. So all you need to look now is that you do not vote for more than four. You have to vote for four. I now ask delegations to please check your ballots one more time and make sure that you voted for no more than four candidates. In case you wish to replace your ballot, you may bring the old ballot to the table in front of the podium and a new ballot will be provided. If you haven't made a mistake and you want to replace the ballot, please come to the podium. We shall now proceed to the collection of ballot papers. Delegations that have not received a ballot paper will be invited to approach the podium to receive one and cast their vote in a few minutes. I invite the tellers to accompany the conference officers as they collect the ballot papers. So, please collect the ballot papers. We have now completed the fifth round of voting. I kindly request you to remain in your seats until the tellers, the conference officers, and I have left the room. We shall reconvene at 3 o'clock as scheduled to provide the results and continue with the vote if necessary. The meeting is suspended.